Okay, I ended up having to record this video because it came out just so on point that I kind of got freaked out. And I have been doing tarot for a few months now, and I'm pretty much a self-taught person, just going with what I feel in my spirit that God's trying to tell me. But the more that I do it, it's like the more elaborate that they're getting and the more that I'm trusting. And so I just wanted to show you guys the stuff I just pulled, and I'll actually make a real video later, like my real official first video. But so we have the DF, Divine Feminine, suffering rejection and abandonment, as well as the Divine Masculine. That's a reflection for sure of the rejection and abandonment. But he tends to go into his pride and ego, which causes his fall. But this is what causes feelings of avoidance and being numb and being cold towards each other. But what I had coming in is the King of Cups. So he's going to come in with his love and his emotion, Knight of Wands, super fast and passionately. Who? The King of Swords, the person that has made up his mind, possibly Gemini, made his mind to come in and have a message of apology. Which then causes abundance inside and out because you're transmuting that hate and whatever blocks between you guys. It's important to be around your soul tribe, and it's important to trust in divine timing. Wait, get some sleep, rest if you need, but have faith and patience. And we got this reflection card. And it says, like, it's not the right time right now, but a year from now. And meditation brings answers. So that's where I believe that reflection card comes in, because we need to reflect inside of ourselves and meditate on that light to be able to transmute and clear these things inside of ourselves that's holding us back from our paths. And then this choose a new direction, choose to forgive. When they come forward to apologize, choose to forgive, okay? Because where there was deception, this masculine, this divine masculine wearing his false mask, being sneaky, lying about his feelings, there is going to be reconciliation a year from now. And he is going to come and express his love. And you should be in a place at that time that you can accept that love and know that you're worthy of that love and to give that love without fear. Because this is true love. So stay optimistic about your love life. Remain having positive thinking, saying positive affirmations, saying positive things out your mouth. And there's that faith again. That faith. Faith here to bring that romance in. And then over here, we have the horse and carriage, wedding, marriage. He's gonna come and chase. He's going to come and chase you to bring forth this justice and this balance between the two of you and have a brand new, beautiful start. I don't know if you guys see a lot of red birds, cardinals. I do all the time. And so over here, we got this self-imprisonment of the mind, right? Stuck in poverty. This could be both you, Divine Feminine and Divine Masculine, probably at separate times. Like for me, I think I experienced all this stuff first, and I think he's experiencing it now. But we have the self-imprisonment of the mind, poverty, bad health, okay? And then once it's like we suffer these things alone because we're not working as a team, and then we come over here, there's courtship with a mature man. Okay, so once you've learned certain lessons and things that you've gone through, then you can come forward and be mature and be able to date. And you, Divine Feminine, are getting that high honor. The high honor of who you are as an individual, what you bring. And this is going to come in fast. Oh, it could ruffle people's feathers. Oh, yeah. Because some people might not understand why they think, like, why do you deserve these things? But it's none of their business because you are a divine feminine. That's why. Because it is your destiny. That is why. Okay? And your masculine will honor you. And then we have here the Prince of Swords, which is the Knight of Swords. Here we have Justice again. He's coming in to bring balance and justice of love. There's the Gemini again. Of course, my divine masculine is a Gemini. The Lovers. Justice of coming in, bringing justice of this love. Twin flames, baby. Eight of Wands, fast, rapid communication. About what? About wanting to work together. Three of Discs. Three of Pentacles. Because why? They know. Divine Feminine, the Divine Masculine knows that he left you out in the cold. How does he know? Because he is experiencing what you have already experienced. This bad health can be physical or it can be mental, like depression. So I just wanted to share that. I wasn't ready to do an actually official video and introduce myself, but there it is. Thank you for watching. Click like, share, and subscribe.